Hi everyone, let's continue our conversation on nonlinear regression. So in this topic, we are going to work on the log regression. So when you have a nonlinear regression, it can be a polynomial regression, it can be a log regression, or it can be any other types of regression. But polynomial and log regression probably are the two most common nonlinear regression models you will see. So log regression is more like, and the pattern is more like in this way. So if you see my graph here, it is changing like very quickly and then it slows down. So it's more like in that sense. So what we are going to use today is called growth data. So we are going to check if the growth rate is affected by the nutrients. And how can we use nutrient to model growth rate of plants? So the data we have imported is called growth. I'm going to import it again and I'm going to link it in the video. So if you go to that data set, you can see this is called growth data, and you can also see there is a variable named growth. So I'm going to change my data set into growth data because I don't want to be confused by the variable or the data set. So now you can see my growth data is imported through this line of R code that is generated automatically. And I can actually run the names function on the growth data. And you can see I have two variables. Growth is my response and the nutrient is my predictor. And you can draw a quick plot to see what is happening there. Like for those two variables, what is happening? How does the predictor affect the response? So you can run the plot and you can see it is kind of a little curved pattern. It goes up quickly and slows down. So one thing we can do here is definitely to try a log regression, and you can use LM for that. So you can do LM on the growth versus nutrient, but I'm going to take a log of the nutrient and then I let data equals growth data. So that is how we set up the model for regression, for log regression. And you can take the name log.model and then you can run the summary of that log.model so that you can see what are the coefficients and whether they are significant or not. So you can see this model is pretty good because the R squared is so high, and it also checks maybe the log regression is good. And you can also draw a graph to check, to double confirm that it works well using this type of regression. So you should run a package called tidyverse. If you haven't installed it before, you may need to type install.packages with double quotation mark, type in tidyverse. Run that line first and then run the library function. And now we are going to draw some graphs. So I'm going to start with graph growth data, and then I use my ggplot function to assign some aesthetic information. So I'm going to let my x equals nutrient and y equals growth. So that is my drawing paper. And then I can add the geometric objects, geom point. So like this one, so that is for drawing a scatter plot. And the next step, I want to add my log regression model to the scatter plot, which I will be use stat underline smooth function, and I specify the method equals lm, and then the formula equals y tilde log of x. And I don't want to see the standard error, the shaded area. So I let SE equals false. And that's about it. Let me run this line and see if it happens. Yep, so you can see this is my X and this is my Y. And the dots are the actual dots that we recorded in the data. And the blue line is actually the log regression model line. So you can see this line actually describes the data very well. And from the summary of the log model, you can see the coefficients there. And if you want to type the model equation, it will be growth equals 0.69 plus 5.10 times log of nutrients. So it is just that easy. So you can see the log nutrients affects growth by 5.1 as one change in the log nutrient. So that's about it. Thank you.